Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about object-oriented programming in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Hey, welcome back. This video is the start of the object-oriented programming portion of the series. The abbreviation people use is OOP, also pronounced as OOP. Now, objects, they can be intimidating, but they're really not that bad once you get to know them. So look around you right now. You are surrounded by different objects. Next to me, I have a phone, a desk, a computer, and a coffee cup. And you can hear me knocking on it right now. Unfortunately, it's empty. So we can use programming to imitate objects in the real world. Anything you can think of, really. An object uses a class. For example, I have a class called car, and we're going to be constructing some car objects. So, with objects, they contain attributes and methods. Think of attributes as the characteristics that this object has, and methods as the different actions that this object can perform. For example, let's list some of the attributes of a coffee cup. These are the characteristics of my coffee cup. So, for example, let's say that the color of this coffee cup is white. I could store this within a string variable within the class called color. And we can assign this a string value such as white. What about a temperature? That could be a double variable, and let's say that this is room temperature at 20 degrees Celsius. And then what about a status like if it's empty or is it full? This could be a Boolean value such as true or false. And unfortunately, my coffee cup is empty, so empty will equal true. Now, what kinds of actions can this coffee cup perform? Let's say we have a drink method, and when we call this method, we can print a message such as, you drink from the cup. Or what about a spill method? If we were to call the spill method in case I decide to spill my coffee everywhere, we could say, you spilled your coffee everywhere. So all an object really is a bundle of defining attributes and methods, the characteristics of an object, and what actions that this object can perform. And for today's video, we're going to be creating some car objects. Why? Because, well, I like cars. So we need to create a different class, another class. So you can either do this within the same Java file or a separate Java file. So if you were to create a class within the same Java file, make sure that you declare this class outside of the main class that you're working with. But I like to keep my code organized into different Java files. So for me, I'm going to create another Java file. So within my project folder, I'm going to go to File, New, Class, and I'm going to call this class Car because we're constructing car objects, and then click Finish. So I have two classes within my project folder, one called Main, for you it may be named something different, and a Car class. So we're going to be using this Car class to define the attributes and methods of what our cars should have. But if you decide to write this within the same Java file, you'll probably write something like this, but I'm just going to keep these as separate files. Now, what kinds of attributes should our car have? Let's start defining a few. Let's say a make and model. These could be string variables. So let's say string make and pick one of your favorite cars. Let's say string make equals Chevrolet. And we could also have a model, like string model equals Corvette, because I like Corvettes. What about a year? This could be an integer, int year. And let's say this is a 2020 Chevrolet Corvette. What about a color? String color equals maybe blue. And what about a price? This could be a double variable such as double price. Let's say that this car is 50,000 US dollars and 0 cents. That's probably enough attributes for this example. Now, what kinds of actions, what kinds of methods would we like our car objects to be able to perform? Let's define two methods, a method for drive and a method for brake. So let's define these. Let's say void drive. And what do we want to do when we call this drive function? Let's have a simple print line statement that says, you drive the car. Let's also create a method called brake. void break system.out.println, you step on the brakes. And that should be good for this example. So these are all of the attributes of the car, the defining characteristics, and these are the methods, what actions our car object can perform. Now let's head back to our main class. This is how to construct an instance of another class. We're going to be constructing a car object. So first we begin with the name of the class, which is car. Next, we can create a unique name for this instance of the class, this unique car object, and I will just call this my car to keep it simple, equals new, and then the name of the class again, followed by a set of parentheses, then a semicolon. So my car now has these attributes. It's a 2020 Chevy Corvette that's blue, and the price is $50,000. And it has two methods, a drive method and a brake method. So let's display some of the characteristics of this car. We can do that within a println statement. And if we want to display or access one of the attributes of this car, we type in the name of the car, which is my car, dot, and then whatever attribute you want to display. Let's display the model. So when we run this, we'll create a car object, and it's called my car, and we're going to print the model. And in the console window, it's going to display the model. Let's display a few of the other attributes too. So let's repeat the process. We type in the name of the object. The name of this object is called my car. I would like to access the make this time. And the make is an attribute, a variable found within this class. So this is going to print the make and the model, and this is a Chevy or Chevrolet Corvette. Now, what if we want to access or perform one of these methods? It's the same process as before, really. So we type in the name of the object, dot, and then the method we would like to call. So we are looking for the drive method, and that is right here. And let's turn these two lines into a comment. So we're going to call the drive method of my car. And it says, you drive the car in the console window. Now let's apply the brakes. So we type in the name of the car or the object, dot, and we're going to use the brake method this time. You step on the brakes. Now with classes, we can reuse a class to instantiate multiple instances of this class, meaning that we can reuse this class to create multiple objects, not just one. So let's reuse this car class to create a second car. Let's pretend that we own two cars now. So let's repeat the steps for creating a car. So we type in the name of the class, car, and we need a unique name for this car object. Let's call this car my car 2, I guess, equals new car. And I think I'm going to rename my car as my car 1. So my car is no longer recognized, so let's just change the name to my car 1. So this will display the make and the model of my car 1, and it's still a Chevrolet Corvette. Now let's display the make and the model of my car 2 following these same steps. So in order to display these, let's write this within a println statement. So we are working with my car 2. We are going to type that name, my car 2, followed by whatever we want to access. We would like to access the make as well as the model. So I'm going to change this to my car 2.model. And I'll add a print line statement just to help separate these within the console window. So what we get is that both of these cars, my car 1 and my car 2, are both Chevrolet Corvettes. So the reason behind this is that with our car class, it's acting as a blueprint. And we're saying that whenever we construct an instance of this class, a car object, all of them are going to be Chevrolet Corvettes, the year 2020, they're blue, and they are all $50,000, and they only have a drive and brake method. And to solve this problem, because we don't want all of our cars to be Chevrolet Corvettes, I mean, that wouldn't be a bad problem to have in real life though, but it's not practical for programming. So what we're going to be doing in the next video is learning about constructors, how we can construct objects that have different characteristics, different attributes, so that all of our objects are not the exact same. So if you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's an introduction to object-oriented programming in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.